Aries Sun, Moon, Rising. I'm Christy Forsyth with Clarity by Christy. I am a soul therapist and an intuitive that connects with the angelic energy, and I help the helpers, the light bringers, and the soulpreneurs of this world to live their most magical life. So if that's you, make sure you hit that subscribe button with the bell for notifications for all the videos that I'm sharing here on the channel, whether it's tarot scopes or all the other videos that I'm sharing here. So we are going to dive into your February 2020. What do you need to know? How can you best navigate this month? And what messages do the angels have for you? And the first thing that I want to say is that as I was preparing myself to get ready for this reading, I just kept hearing, open the blinds, open the blinds. And I looked over and my blinds in my office were very much open already. And then I realized that this is actually a message for you. This is a message from your angels to you to make sure that you're opening the blinds to your life. You know, where have you been kind of shutting yourself in? Where have you been spending time in dark places? Where have you been maybe isolating yourself more? This has been universally a period of time where we have been more I say I've been spending time in my bubble. You know what I mean? We've been spending more time away from people. We've been spending more time reflecting. We've been spending more time rebalancing things like that. But we also have to make sure that we're getting out and about, that we are reconnecting with people, that we're letting the light in, you know, whether it's, you know, literally opening your blinds or that you are just choosing to let the light in your life in whatever way that speaks to you. So let's dive into the actual cards. The first cards that we have here are, I have three cards here for the overarching theme that you guys can expect through this month. And I do feel like it's been, you know, there's been a lot of challenges for you guys, and this card is showing me that you are going to find yourself through this month beginning to feel victorious over some of the battles that you have been waging, okay? This is the Six of Fire card is like a soldier coming back from battle, and he's being celebrated, and he's happy and joyful, but he is coming back from battle. He's been through a lot. He's had to do a lot of work. He's had to go through a lot to get himself to this place. So it's being celebrated, but at the same time, it's been really hard. So honor how hard it's been, but also celebrate whatever these things are that are showing up in your life. And if they haven't yet, understand that victory is coming, okay? And so whatever these things are that you're feeling victorious about, it's time to celebrate. It's time to let the light in. It's time to be excited about life again, because I feel like through the disconnection a little bit, there has been a little bit of a disconnection in joy, spark, happiness, excitement, fun, all of that stuff, okay? Because again, we have worked on creating this energy, and I think that this is what has been sort of a priority for you guys, not just this month, but previous to this, is this feeling of being safe, wanting to feel safe, wanting to feel comfortable, wanting to feel in a bubble, like I said, you know, and I do feel like this is going to continue a bit through this month. We are going to be through part of this month in Mercury retrograde, and that very much creates that energy anyway, where we are taking time away to just reflect. And so while you are doing this, while you're reflecting, again, make sure you are opening the blinds too. You are letting the light in as well, but letting yourself enjoy these feelings of safety and security, and letting the reflections that are trying to come through your mind come and marinate in your mind and show you some clarity on the other side of this retrograde. And we also have, though, a suggestion for what you might be doing, and this is the Samaritan card, okay? So this is about getting out and helping. So this isn't about just staying home and feeling safe, or staying, you know, in your typical routine that you have and staying safe. This is about shaking things up a little bit too, and doing things that are meant to help people. That, you know, so this can be you getting out there and volunteering. This can be you, you know, just trying to show kindness to others in some way. But this is a little bit more of like a structured energy, okay? So planning it out, maybe setting intentions with some friends, or even on your own to go out to volunteer for an event, or to help with something, or to get started with something. But this is going to, I think, help shake things up for you a little bit, help to bring in some more good vibes, help to shake up this stuck energy that I'm just seeing here in the spread, okay? So overall, the energy really is like just kind of a standstill and not feeling like there's a lot of progress moving here, okay? But as we progress further into the month, I feel like this is where the progress comes. So some of this is about like we just have to be in this process. This process is purposeful. And the card that we have here is the Challenges card, and it's the Six of Air, okay? So this is like, things kind of just feel status quo, or things don't feel like they're getting better, or things don't feel like they're moving forward. And so this is going to be a challenge for you this month because it is going to feel stuck and stagnant. And this is where that getting out there and doing good things for other people is going to play an important role in terms of balancing out this energy, okay? I do feel like with this next card that we have here in the gifts category, the Page of Earth reverse, that you're going to be exploring the idea of potentially learning something new. And this might be actually going back to school. This might be just becoming somebody's apprentice or learning something from somebody. This might be just a short, you know, class that you take online or a certification program or something like that. But if you see opportunities for new learning and you feel pulled to take them, I would take them because I think that this is going to be helpful for you in moving forward. This is going to be an important stepping stone for the moving forward and to help it to not feel quite so stuck and so stagnant. But I do feel like you're going to find yourself sitting on that a little bit. Don't sit on that too long. You know, if you feel pulled to it, don't overthink it. Don't think about it for too long. Just go for it. You know, it doesn't have to be some major 6-year program, you know, just something that whatever you feel pulled to, something that you want to learn. Maybe it's even just a self-help book that you have been feeling called to learn and to follow that you let yourself sort of dive right into. The next card that we have here is in the lessons category, and this is the Two of Earth, okay? And the Two of Earth, when it's upright, this is the Two of Earth reverse. So when it's upright, it can be like you have too much going on at once. And this is almost feeling like a boredom instead. Like, I don't know, like it just things feel like it's at a lull. It's not feeling like the ability to really focus on any one particular thing. And this is really where I feel compelled to say, like, you have to force it a little bit. You're going to have to force it. You're going to have to push yourself. You're going to have to go for it. Make sure that you're taking care of stuff. Make sure that you're not getting so caught in this stuck energy that you're not progressing, that you're not moving forward, that you're not getting things done. And I think that it would be helpful to really have a plan each and every day for what it is that you're wanting to accomplish, because or whatever it is that works for you to get things moving, because I feel like we have to get things moving and get some stuff going here with this, okay? And then the next card that we have here is the Two of Fire reversed. And so this is in the advice category. And again, this is about not really moving forward a ton, feeling a little hesitant to move forward. This can be even hesitant to move forward with meeting new people, with allowing new opportunities, especially in regard to, like, this can sometimes be a new relationship that's trying to come in that we're just sort of like, no, I don't feel ready for that, or even a new business opportunity, new business partnership opportunity that's coming in, and we're like, oh, I'm not sure, I'm gonna give some thought to that. And it's not that it's bad to think about things, because yes, we want to make good decisions for ourselves, right? But don't be so stuck in your ways that you're not allowing new things to come in, that you're not allowing yourself to receive the things that the universe is trying to bring in. Don't let your bubble be so strong that nothing can get through it, okay? Because I see new things coming in for you, and the next cards that we're going to talk about really are new opportunities, but you have to be open to it, and you have to allow it, and you have to open the blinds. You have to open the door, right? Open the door to what's trying to come in, to the new things that are coming in. This oftentimes is connected with career stuff, but it can also be a new partnership in regard to a new relationship, a new friendship, or a reconnection of a friendship or a partnership that has existed in the past. And the next card that we have here is the Ace of Fire upright. Okay, so, and this is the what else in the what else category. This is where we're going, okay? And we have the Ace of Fire. This is a great energy. The Ace of Fire is an exciting new opportunity that's trying to come through. And this is upright. So I feel like whatever is happening through this stuckness and through this processing, you just figure it out, and you allow yourself to open the blinds, open the door, and you allow these opportunities to come through. This is about career advancement, you know, so improvement in your career, growth in your business. This is about a new opportunity, a new business. So it's a great time for you to build on your business, to focus on getting a raise at work, to take on a new position, to look for new work, to be open to new opportunities. And it doesn't necessarily even have to be your job that you get paid for. It can be, you know, just being open to serving in the ways that you're feeling called to serve here on this planet, and that might be changing right now, that might be shaking it up. Maybe you've been serving sort of one role for quite some time, and now you're really getting to know yourself, where you're at right now, and deciding, no, I want to do this in a different way, or I'm really feeling called to help people in this way now. And so following through with that is going to be really powerful for you. This is a great energy. And this is also about raising your standards with the universe, okay? So what are you expecting out of others? What are you expecting out of yourself? What are you expecting out of the things that are arriving into your experience? And can you aim higher? You know, can you ask for more? Can you set harder, higher goals? Can you expect people to treat you in the way that you would expect them to treat your best friend? You know, can you treat you in the way that you would treat your best friend? Can you be more loving to yourself? Can you force yourself to follow through with things that you have promised to yourself, that in the same way that you would do for somebody else that you love? Okay, so those kinds of things. And we also have, you know, so we may have this new romantic energy coming in, because we have the Prince card. Okay, so the Prince card says romantic charm and potential for power. So this can be your prince coming in, you know. This can be someone wonderful arriving into your life. This can be you connecting to your power. This can be you beginning to understand your power, beginning to understand your potential for leadership. With all this with all these fire energy cards here, this can be connected to work as well, and you understanding that, well, maybe I do have a little bit more potential than I realized, and I'm going to be aiming higher. This also can suggest that you are the romantic one, that you have, you know, more charm and more power than you realize, and you're beginning to understand that more and more as you navigate this month and as you go through this internal process of things throughout this month. But I think that ultimately what you guys are moving toward is some really good stuff. You've just got to let the light in, right? You've got to be open to receiving the things that are trying to come in for you, and you've got to take action on the things that you feel called to take action on. So those are your messages for the month of February 2020. If you guys like this video, make sure you hit that like button, and I would love to hear from you in comments below. If you haven't subscribed yet to my channel, please make sure that you do that down below with the subscribe button. And if you want to learn more about me or my services at Clarity, you can check me out at discoveryawakening.com. Take care, guys. I'll see you soon.